Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Please stand.
Ye watchers and ye holy ones, bright seraphs, cherubim and thrones, raise the glad strain, alleluia. Cry out, dominions, princedoms, powers, virtues, archangels, angels, choirs. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Respond, ye souls in endless rest, ye patriarchs and prophets blessed. Alleluia, alleluia. Ye holy 12 and martyrs strong, all saints triumphant, raise the song. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Oh, friends, in gladness let us sing, triumphant anthems echoing. Alleluia, alleluia. To God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit, three and one. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. you are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The community of believers was of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common. With great power, the apostles bore witness to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus, and great favor was accorded them all. There was no needy person among them, for those who owned property or houses would sell them, bring the proceeds of the sale, and put them at the feet of the apostles, and they were distributed to each according to need. The word of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is God. His love is everlasting. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is God. His love is everlasting. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his mercy endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his mercy endures forever. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is God. His love is everlasting. I was hard-pressed and was falling, but the Lord helped me. My strength and my courage is the Lord, and he has been my Savior. The joyful shout of victory in the beatings of the just. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Lord, His love is everlasting. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Give thanks to the Lord, for He is God. His love is everlasting.
A reading from the first letter of St. John. Beloved, everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ is begotten by God, and everyone who loves the Father loves also the one begotten by Him. In this way we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey His commandments. For the love of God is this, that we keep His commandments. And His commandments are not burdensome, for whoever is begotten by God conquers the world. And the victory that conquers the world is our faith. Who indeed is the victor over the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came through water and blood, Jesus Christ, not by water alone, but by water and blood. The Spirit is the one that testifies, and the Spirit is truth. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
You believe in me, Thomas, because you have seen me, says the Lord. Blessed are they who have seen me, but still believe.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you. Then he said to Thomas, put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe. Thomas answered and said to him, my Lord and my God. Jesus said to him, if you come to believe because you have seen me, blessed are those who have not seen and have believed. Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord. These things have been written so that we may come to believe. Blessed are those who believe who have not seen. And so we have heard the gospel message, the good news of the Lord's resurrection, and we have believed. And our faith is our victory, as we hear in our second reading from the first letter of John. In the Gospel of John, we hear the good news that Jesus is alive as he speaks, peace be with you, to his disciples and to us. It is always the Easter greeting of Jesus to give peace. The risen Lord came to achieve peace by the healing power of his death and his resurrection, and he achieves it. The power of his empty tomb and his risen presence among his disciples in his church down to our own day is what gives us life and hope in salvation. It is our faith, our belief in him, that makes the difference for our lives and helps us to see the goodness of God present among us in the risen Lord. Thomas, in seeing, does not have weaker faith, for he comes to believe. After all, because he got to put his hand into Jesus' side and see the nail marks in his hands, we believe. He could pass on that testimony to us, seeing the risen Jesus in the flesh, in his true and spiritual body, truly Jesus because he bore the wounds of the cross. Truly the crucified one who truly died is truly alive. And we hear the fruits of his death and resurrection in our first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, the early church helping the needs of those less fortunate by sharing their goods, their wealth, their property with all who needed it, living that true common life of union and communion in the power of the Holy Spirit in the risen Lord. We hear in our second reading the three great witnesses, the water and the blood, the death of Jesus, the Spirit witnessing, the Spirit, the water, and the blood, testifying to the true death and the true life of Jesus Christ. The water and blood poured out from the side of Jesus on the cross, as we know on Good Friday, symbolizing baptism with water and the Eucharist with blood, comes the very life of the church, the very life that Jesus came to bring. The new life of baptism that makes new members of the church, new disciples, and the blood of Christ and his body that feed the new disciples so that they may grow into the likeness of their divine master. Baptism and Eucharist are what make the church and make us have the new life in Jesus Christ and continue to grow in that life. And so we see in the wounds of Jesus, his pierced side, the fountain of our salvation. St. Thomas the doubter led to so much faith and so much belief in our faith, because he helps to point us again to the fount that is Jesus Christ, the fountain of love that poured from his side, that made us into his disciples and continues to help us grow. Baptism and Eucharist and the salvation that come from those sacraments and the life we receive in our daily prayer and our daily good works in our hearing the word of God and living the Easter life that Jesus came to bring. So truly he says and gives his peace to us. He breathed the Holy Spirit upon his apostles so that they might forgive sins. On this Divine Mercy Sunday, we celebrate God's mercy and forgiveness given us in our risen Lord, who died for us that we might have life. How wonderful it is to know the witness of the water and blood flowing from the side of Christ. On the cross, he has achieved our healing and our salvation. And in his resurrection, we get a taste of eternal life. So let us ever be thankful in this octave day of Easter, 8 days that liturgically are still one day, the very day of Easter. Let us sing Alleluia and praise the Lord and believe in the light of Christ and the light of this Easter candle, symbolizing the reality of Jesus's light. His light has touched our hearts. At Easter, we have come to know the goodness of God present in him through his death and resurrection. Let us seek to live this new life then and believe in the words handed down to us, the testimony of Thomas and the other apostles, that Jesus came to bring us life. And we know that life because we pray. We know that life because we worship him. We know that life because we receive the sacraments. We know that life because we hear his divine word proclaimed. Let us especially open our hearts so that in the interior, the deep recesses of our hearts, the very core of our being, we too may believe and hear and know the power of God present in us, that the graces of our baptism and confirmation may be released, and we may know the power of the risen Lord manifest in our daily living and in the joy we have as disciples, as believers in the truth of the resurrection of Jesus.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Seeking the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us offer our Father our petitions. For Pope Francis, our Bishop Robert, and all the bishops, may Christ draw them ever closer to himself.
Thank you. Thank you.
not seen, ear has not heard, what God has ready for those who love Him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God. When pain and suffering are from the past, in Ezra's saints have trod, yet ever through the music rings to Jesus' living song of God. Eye has not seen, ear has not heard, what God has ready for those who love Him. Spirit of love, come give us the mind of Jesus. Teach us the wisdom of God.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal Sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and hearts, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a few announcements.
Just a reminder before you leave, to leave the kneelers down in the pews where you are at so our volunteers do know where to clean to be ready for the next masses tomorrow. Also a reminder, I meant to have an announcement a couple weeks ago, but forgot that though the Indiana mask mandate may be expired as of April 6th, we will continue at our bishop's direction to continue to wear masks here at Mass and try to maintain social distance as best we can so that we can keep everyone safe. As we can see, we're more and more people are coming to Mass, and we were really packed, of course, last weekend. So let's do what we can to keep everyone safe and feeling safe. Also, next weekend begins our Catholic Services Appeal kickoff for 2021. I believe the diocese has already sent a mailing out with cards. We will be sending out a letter from me with cards as well this coming week. You can mail your envelope to the diocese, as it says, or bring them with you here to Mass, already filled out to place in the collection baskets. But it's a very important collection, and I will be speaking about that at next weekend's Masses. I won't have you do that now. We do have an announcement to make about a change that will affect Our Lady of Grace Parish starting July 1st. Some good news and some sad news. The sad news is that Father Gregory, our associate pastor, will be leaving us on July 1st. The relative good news there is that he won't be going far. He will become the administrator of St. James just down the road. And that means that will affect my assignment. I will continue to be your administrator here at Our Lady of Grace, but I will no longer be administrator of St. James. Part of the reason for that, along with my diocesan assignments that I have at the Marriage Tribunal and in the Chancery, frankly, pastoring two parishes, and that is quite hectic. It has been a very challenging and fun 2 years, but it will certainly be much easier to pastor one parish along with my diocesan assignments. And I'm very glad to say that I'll be staying here, hopefully for a good long time, but we will see about that. But remember to pray for Father Gregory, a very young priest. Usually someone ordained 4 years does not get such an assignment, so pray for him and be supportive of him. And we'll certainly have a few months to say farewell, but one of the things the bishop told us to say is that St. James and Our Lady of Grace need to continue to work together and continue to build common activities, common ministries, and common life. So Father Gregory and I will be at work with all of you to do that. So pray for us. I'm very happy about this change, and I'm happy to be staying here with all of you. So pray for us, and let's continue to pray for one another. I think that's all I had to say about that. Usually I forget something, but if I remember, I'll tell you next week. So please stand.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Hallelujah.
Sing with all the saints in glory, sing the resurrection song. Death and sorrow, earth's dark story, to the former days belong. All around the clouds are breaking, soon the storms of time shall cease. In God's likeness, people walking, know the everlasting peace. Oh, what glory far exceeding all that eye has yet perceived! holiest hearts for ages pleading, ever that for joy conceived. God has promised, Christ prepares it, there on high our welcome waits. Every humble spirit shares it, Christ has passed the eternal gates.